Maybe I waited too long.
He looks very angry.
Maybe I played my cards wrong.
Yo, check it.
Welcome back to another reaction video. My name is JERiCK.
And I'm Adriana.
Today's reaction, we're doing Mr. Daryl Ong. And you guys already know, if you've been following me for a while, this guy is a great singer.
Heard of him. Never heard of
him. She's never heard of Daryl Ong.
No.
This is going to be your initial reaction.
Okay. Oh, man. Now he's really going to know what I think of him.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, I've never seen this, so
I guess. I have some positive thoughts, giving up positive vibes.
Yeah.
We love Ed Sheeran. I also really love this song.
And
so, yeah. I've actually never heard a cover of this. This is also the first cover of the song I'm going to hear.
Oh.
So let's hope.
So I guess let's just hope this is going to be good.
Let's just go. Let's just dive right
dive
into it.
Into it.
I love my puns. Okay. It's really different already. Oh.
Maybe I came on too strong. Maybe I waited too long.
He looks very angry.
Maybe I played my cards wrong. Oh, just a little bit wrong. Baby, I apologize for it. I can fall, I can fly. Here in your airplane, I could live, I could die, hanging on the words you say. I've been known to give my all and jumping in harder than 10,000 rocks on the lake. So don't call me baby unless you mean it. Don't tell me you need me if you don't believe it. So let me know the truth before I dive right into you. You're a mystery. I have traveled the world and there's no other girl, no one like you. And what's your history? Do you have a tendency to lead some people on? 'Cause I heard you do it. I can fall, I can fly. Here in your airplane, I could live, I could die, hanging on the words you say. I've been known to give my all and lie awake every day, don't know how much I can take. So don't call.
Okay. Okay. Oh, I have lots of things to say. Okay, I probably have way more. You go first.
Okay, so I'm gonna, that's what I was going to say. Let me go first, since you have a lot of things to say. I've actually never heard of the original song, so I have nothing to compare it to.
Oh, man.
So I don't know what kind of changes he made, aside from probably the runs, because, you know, Daryl Ong does a lot of runs. And that was great. Yeah, because I have no idea
okay.
what the original sounds like.
Anything else?
No.
No? Okay,
I'm just going to let you be.
Okay, we love Ed Sheeran. I like this guy, too. One thing I noticed right from the bat is he definitely took, like, a different interpretation of this piece. Because I think from the very beginning of this version, it was very heartfelt and emotional. And you can just tell, especially with how he sets it up with the intro, with the instruments. In the original version, it's just Ed and, like, some guitar. And then it's a little bit more edgy.
Okay.
This is a little bit more ballad. Like, he definitely took a different, like, interpretation, which is not wrong at all. Just listening to how different this one is, I feel like he took it more of an interpretation of kind of really, really sad. Made it into a really, really sad song. Actually, I was, like, feeling emotional. Like, he took it as in, like, hey, yo, like, why are you messing with my heart this way? Like, this is, I'm so devastated. Like, I would do all this for you, and then this is how you're treating me, as I'm just, like, going in there. I mean, same story with Ed, but I feel like with Ed, when he sings this piece, it's more, what up, dude? Like,
edgy.
why are you treating me like this?
Huh, okay.
Like, don't call me baby. I'm so annoyed with you. Like, kind of thing. But the way he did it was like, I've invested so much in you.
More a lot of a hurt and sadness in
there. Yeah, more hurt and sadness, as if in Ed's version, it could be the same exact thing. I don't know the reason why he wrote this song, but listening to Ed's version, it's more, who do you think I am? Like, don't treat me like this.
Huh.
Same thing with this guy, but it's definitely more on the hurtful spectrum. It moved me in a different way, because, like I said, it's already different, especially since this is more ballad-like.
Yeah, yeah.
And Ed's version is more edgy and rock-ish, kind of.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, this version took you on a different journey of, like, if you consider a relationship, Ed's relationship is in a different position for this song, and then this guy's relationship. Like, I don't know if both of them are in relationships, like, where things are going wrong, but very two different approaches to music. I think it's very interesting. Both are very good. It's kind of amazing how different we can interpret music, you know?
That was great. That was a very detailed response and reaction.
Does anyone ever pay attention to this when they listen to covers? Like, different approaches, different ways they portray the story that's in there? Like,
kind
maybe
of,
that's just because,
like,
I'm emotional.
No, I think it's just like, you see it a little bit differently. If you guys don't know her background, she's actually, what's your major?
Gosh. I study, oh God, I'm going to get a lot of criticism. I study music at school, and we look into that.
And that's why she has a lot of things to say, because
she's probably used to kind of like
breaking things down and analyzing things. And
yeah.
That's why I wanted her on this.
Oh, thanks.
Because I don't know what to say. I just think it's either good or it's bad.
It's good. It's very good. No interpretation is wrong.
True.
Keep that in mind. It's just
like I don't know any, like, musical terms or anything like that.
Well, now that you know what I'm talking about, next time you listen to a cover or watch a performance, see how different each performance can be. Like, see if the cover artist interpreted it in a different way from how it's originally presented. And, you know, that's what makes it unique. That's what people like. No one wants to hear someone sing something just like the original. Then it's
true.
Not,
that is true.
It's like, where's the authenticity of it?
Okay.
And
I get it.
We like authentic things as humans, just
what
we like, and we know what we like. And, yeah, being different is not so bad after all, is it?
Yeah. That was great. That was, love it, love
philosophical
it.
Philosophical talks as well on this show.
But anyways, thanks for watching our reaction video. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. And we'll see you guys on the next one.
Peace out.
Peace.